Gujarat, a hub of culture, heritage, and industry. The little town of Kutch lies in the northwestern region of the state, a region that remains flooded during the monsoon, gathering the salt carried by the rivers emptying into it. This region is designated as a wildlife sanctuary and is home to the last three species of the Asiatic wild lass and several other animals and migratory birds. As the water recedes, migrants from neighboring regions move with their families to work on the salt pans, extracting salt that has been deposited in the region. Salt mining begins with digging wells, extracting sufficient amount of water to fill the pans from where salt is extracted. The water fills well-bounded reservoirs from where it's concentrated and transferred to wide pans. The solar evaporation leads to formation of salt crystals at the bottom. The salt is then collected manually and sold to merchants who crushes, iodizes and packages the salt before selling it to organizations processing and marketing packaged salt. The merchants specify certain quality parameters such as crystal size, which are critical to the quality of the final product. This process is carried out in the non-monsoon period, which lasts for 8 months from September to May. This supply chain, however, has inequity built into it, but the salt pan workers are grossly exploited. The working conditions in the Ran are extremely harsh, with temperatures of 50 degrees Celsius during the day and extreme cold during the nights. The poor workers who do most of the actual labor are paid a measly 16% of the revenues that the merchants make through the sale of salt. The merchant, acting as a middleman, pockets the rest for little value addition to the process. The money required for production, including diesel to power the pumps, is supplied as credit by the merchants, who receive salt from the workers as payment. They have no other avenues of financing due to lack of land ownership. Since the workers remain indebted to the merchants, they have little freedom in finding alternate buyers, and the produce is considered sold in advance, even before the actual production begins. The merchants, already assuming ownership of the salt, issues commands to the workers who work in conditions very similar to bonded labor. The poor working conditions create severe health issues to the workers due to the caustic nature of concentrated salt solution in which they walk and work. Skin diseases, tuberculosis, and night blindness are rampant in the region. The strong glare of the intense desert sun, magnified by the reflection from the salt lakes, gradually impairs the vision of the workers. During the 8 months of salt production, the entire family of salt farmers relocate to the desert, where they live in makeshift huts, separated from each other by long distances. Food and water supplies are brought in from the nearest urban centers at exorbitant prices by the merchants. Water cost for a typical family can be as high as Rs. 500 per month. This cycle of migrations creates severe impediments to the education of the children of the workers, leading to a vicious cycle of them taking up the same profession as they grow up. NGO Gantar has undertaken several innovative steps to ensure that the children are not deprived of basic education during this cycle, enabling them to take up mainstream vocations in the society. Arrangements have been made to continue the education left midway in the home village school through tutors who visit the desert to take classes, avoiding the break in education while the family is in the desert. Innovative methods such as mirrors reflecting the sunlight are used to signal the arrival of the tutor. The children, when observing the signal, make their way through kilometers of dry, barren land to attend the suburb school. The way out of this vicious cycle of exploitation is through education. Watching the children perform a beautiful dance for us, we find a glimmer of hope that these education initiatives will empower them to break free from the life of drudgery endured by their family and look forward to a brighter future. Krishna Nivari Mata Malaki Liyarilo.